Alright, ladies as well as gentlemen, Papa Boris here with some more League of Explorers. In the first video, we did the three normal challenges, and now we're going to do the class challenges, which are really my favorite parts of the of all the solitary, solo adventure things, because you don't have to make a deck to play them, you can just click the play button and then see what happens. Now, to be honest, most of the class challenges, even though I like them in theory better than everything else, have kind of disappointed me, because usually the decks are kind of filled with random crap and don't do anything interesting. So, we'll see if Blizzard did a better job on these. This is the other warrior common, which is just really good. It's a spider tank with taunt. So, Blizzard gave warriors in this expansion at the common slot a strictly better war golem and a strictly better spider tank. I mean, strictly better is a little bit of a stretch because it is a beast rather than a mech. That is a difference that is sometimes significant, but for the most part, strictly better. Alright, so we're up against the Jin again, giving us wishes and playing bad cards like Wisp. So I'm not too concerned. Oh yeah, Bolster. This is like a Bolster thing. Oh my god, I see. Well, unfortunately, that's useless because this Pitsnik's going to kill my shit. So we'll play that. Let's take a look at what minion we get. Ugh, well, I would have liked something that I could play right now. I hate to have the attendee die to the Wisp. It feels bad since I got these bolsters, but I think that's better than just sitting back and doing nothing. I mean, I'm getting a free card every turn, so trading one for one here without making full use of bolster seems okay. Grim Patron seems good because of all the Wisps this thing has in its deck. Alright, it's clearly a bolster deck. Every single minion, I think, has had taunt so far. So I can drop a bolster next turn. It's a bit of card disadvantage, but could be useful. Ah, should have. Yeah, well, I didn't have a chance to play Bolster, obviously, so it's just going to die. And he's even going to use Lava Shock instead of the Wisp, because Wisp is, of course, the most valuable card that Zanar has right now. Dread Corsair, I have no weapons. Well, let's see what spell I get. Interesting. All fair choices. Let's just take the removal card. Let's take another spell here. Slam, slam, I think we'll take the cleave, just stick with the removal, and I'm just gonna play this overpriced Iron for a Grizzly. I think it's better than an alternative. Discover a minion. Alright, so cleave's gonna be good here. I don't get to play Grim Patron. Ah, Whirlwind would have been even better. But it's good that he sacrificed the Wisp, because it allows me to do this and guarantee the kill with cleave. Should I get a minion? Why not? Nightblade, Sap. Well, Sapper's playable right now, so I'm just going to play it. It's never going to trigger his ability because the guy's not going to hold on to six or more cards. But, oh, actually, wait a minute. It might. He does draw a card every single turn. Interesting. Okay, well, I think Sunwalker makes the most sense. Let's just see if I get something. I don't know what I would get that would make me change my mind. Let's take Grommish, seems fine. Kill that thing. And get my first damage on. Alright, so we're really setting up for a huge bolster turn. Get the Senjin and the Tron. What's this? Give a random friendly minion +3/+3. I can see some. Maybe, am I underestimating this? Like with Shadow Flame or something? I don't know. But anyway, we just kill that first and this second. And I actually really want to play more of my cards because of all these wishes that I'm getting. War, so sad. Reno Jackson again. We'll just take the Ghoul because it's the only card that isn't complete trash. Oh, Warsong would have given this +1 attack. Oh my god. All right. So I've got three taunt minions here. I think it might be time to play Bolster. Waiting any more would just be greedy. Okay, there's more than the legally allotted number of bolsters in this deck. I could play a Flesh-Eating Ghoul to start buffing it up as I kill off all the opponent's minions. That seems good. Let's just discover a spell real quick. Commanding Shout, Cleave, or Revenge. I believe it's a coincidence these are all warrior cards, although I haven't seen any other class cards, so I guess the Djinn only gives you cards of your type. Okay, so we'll do that, that, whack. We're threatening some killing action here. Never did end up using Grim Patron. Crush could be good for killing anything huge. Forgotten Torch kills my ghoul. What do we got? 15, 20 damage? Ah, 3 short. I didn't take any direct damage spells. Oh wait, bolster number 3! Oh yes. That's what we needed. I wonder if Blizzard's trying to, like, make a bolster meta happen here. Why did I say Will played? That was totally stupid. But, nice try, Blizzard. It's still a terrible card, and no one should ever play with it. Okay. Well, we got the... Oh, that's so cool. So, Warrior got the, that War Golem thing that gives you Scarabs. So, now is a good time to be Warrior in the arena, because Warriors have their card, but the other classes don't have theirs. At least I believe that's how it should work. Okay, this is the guy with the stone. Hopefully this pre-made deck does a better job of dealing with it than I did. Why is this in anything's deck? Why does this card even exist? Lord. All right, huge toad, which is just pretty much a vanilla 3-2. I mean, honestly, this is sort of upsetting, isn't it? It's a beast, so it's strictly better than a Razorfin or a Bloodfen Raptor, isn't it? Whichever one is the 3-2 for 2 beast. Yeah, this is strictly better than that. That's a little bit depressing. Alright, so, 2-2 discover a 1 cost card. Let's see, I think I'll just hit the staff. Yeah. You really want to have the staff under your control when this guy pops. Alright, so do I throw this? So, what's this? Give your opponent a cursed card while they hold it, take 2 damage on their turn. Seems like a pretty dumb card. I think the cursed card costs like 2 mana, but it's a dumb card in this scenario where it's never going to do anything as long as he's holding the staff. So I think we pop... Well, let me think about this. I can throw the toad at this. There's a 2/3 chance it'll deal a relevant amount of damage somewhere, or a 1/3 chance that it'll be wasted. I think that's pretty good odds. Let's take him. Wait, no! Oh god, that's stupid, because I take 5 damage! Oh, that's dumb. Probably not worth it. Alright, let's pop the imp there. Do this here. Discover a 1-cost card here. Flame Imp seems good in this particular fight. Because you can play it while immune and not take any damage. Does this guy have any mass removal? I don't think he did. Okay, this is looking pretty good, so let's play the curse, I suppose. Oh yeah, life tap's cute, because you don't take damage, but it's better to build the board, I think. So, do I throw stuff at this? Nah. Let's get damage through. He's gonna have to hit the void caller with this guy anyhow, and then with 5 damage left over, I can fill it up here. So I guess cursed, it's the start of your turn. Right, so it's not actually burn, because if they take care of it on their turn, it won't do anything on yours. This guy's pretty good. I can do that, I suppose. Yeah, I think that's fine. Wait, can I kill him? 5, 7, 9. 13? Not quite. Yeah, I'm just gonna play it safe. Let's just do this. Play that guy out for future reference. Oh, it's sort of your... No, I'm wrong. It's in his hand. So yeah, if you play it on your turn, then they're gonna take 2 damage at the start of their turn. So it is at least a two damage face attack. Why did he hit my guy instead of hitting the staff? I guess because I could have just killed the staff. Fair enough. If it's a friendly demon, give it +5/+5. Is this a demon? It's not a demon. So that doesn't actually work. Let's see, I could do 1, 2, +4 is 6, +5 is 11. He's almost dead. Oh, Ancient Shade. Why does that exist? Okay, so let's do that. Hit him in the face. And he's going to almost... I should remember that curse. He almost dies to the curse. So he's just about dead. He has to kill this staff here, doesn't he? Yeah. So he steals the staff, becomes immune. Can he protect it, though? Okay, that's a pretty risky maneuver, all things considered. But I guess it doesn't actually matter because I can just kill this and finish him off however I want to. I could have killed him with the imp. Bonk! And Orsus will not avenge him. Okay, well, that'll do it for the class challenges for this week. Stay tuned until next week when we do the next wing of this adventure. Battlecry, discover a one cost card. Not the most exciting thing I've ever seen, but the warrior, the good warrior cards more than make up for it. If you want to stick around, feel free. If you don't want to stick around, please like and/or subscribe. But yeah, so here is the warlock card. Doesn't seem that great. The warrior card, very, very good in arena. I'm not sure if it's good enough for constructed, because obviously you could just play Dr. Boom. But yeah, it's definitely not as good as Dr. Boom, but it's a really good common card for arena, so really very excited to play Warrior now. And Priest got a good common card as well, so it seems like Blizzard is trying to make arena better. I'm actually looking forward to playing both of the two crappiest classes once the full complement of adventures has been released. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please like and or subscribe. I'll see you again soon. Take care, everybody.